what would you say is the function of the dream for the human being?
It's the way the body talks to itself about its dilemma and the means by which it can rehearse different action patterns about situations that require another way of behaving. It's sort of like a synaptic organization that is looking to collect information before the final pathway of action is formed. So basically, it's how the organism talks to itself in the language of its own social processes, how body shapes are social expressions, and its instinctual shapes, and how it will make a compromise or an organization between what is inherited and what can be influenced so that it fits a situation.
So you were saying that the dream comes from the body.
Correct.
And the dream is an embodied event.
From the beginning. It's the way the body speaks to itself. It's the way that it is capable of organizing a pre-verbal languaging and then using gestures and body shapes to talk about its own dilemma. It's almost it's not a symbolic representation, but it's a way that the body language, which is non-symbolic, but is gestural or behavioral organizations, gets organized as a social conversation of the body with itself. And therefore the body can then understand how it has to behave socially using its own body dilemmas. So say a person who is doesn't have much self-esteem and has a collapsed chest, mm-hmm. or is in the world in a very shy way, could present characters, dream figures that show itself being bigger or stronger or chest up, or showing figures that in fact really dramatize being sort of reserved. And the experience of working with the dream figure is to make a muscular model of the neural model, and in that way you have a muscular neural interaction of which the body can influence its own behavior.
So the dream is also a rehearsal for the future.
It is a rehearsal of possibilities for the being differently in a situation which can have a long-term or a short-term future, immediate or over time.
And can you say more about making the muscular model out of the neural model that you just mentioned?
Well, it goes back to understanding that understanding the human organism from a formative point of view, it's all about patterns of behavior. It's locomotion. It's about going to. It's how you act. The organism is concerned with the dynamics of its action. So it is talking about how to act, which means how the body is organized to express itself. So it's motoric muscular. So in the dream figure, not the dream matrix, but the figures in the dream are motor patterns that are looking for more body, which is more muscular effort, so that the organism mimicking, imitating, assembling a dream figure. I dream of myself opening a door, going for a walk. If you mimic the posture, mm-hmm. you then organize a muscular organization, which is a way the body will talk to itself about changing its own action pattern and its experience of itself in different organized postures, which it can then make a rehearsal. How will I do this? Or should I do this when I talk to my boss or when I'm in the subway station or so forth? So that muscular model is the way the body talks to itself at a primary level and as a self-correcting level. Most people think that you interpret it symbolically or emotionally, mm-hmm. you will change something. But you have to change the action pattern because that's the primary language. That's the dynamic.